Today, we're going to set up and integrate Node-RED with Home Assistant. We're going to look at the browser-based editor, go over some of the available nodes, and we're also going to create an automation so you can get started with Node-RED. So what is Node-RED? Node-RED is a programming tool for creating automations more visually. It provides a browser-based editor where you can create flows, aka automations, using a wide range of nodes. Node-RED is the perfect companion for Home Assistant, so instead of writing automations in YAML, you can simply wire together nodes to create a flow. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is install the Node-RED add-on. So open Home Assistant, go to Hassio, Add-on Store, select Node-RED, and then click on Install. When the installation finishes, go to Config, and under Credential Secret, set up a password that will be used for encryption. The Node-RED editor also has a dark theme available. To enable it, you can change the dark mode value from false to true. Click on Save, and before you start the add-on, toggle the switch on the sidebar, so an option to open Node-RED becomes available on the Home Assistant sidebar. Now click on Start and give it a couple of minutes for Node-RED to initiate. After Node-RED is up and running, you can refresh Home Assistant and the Node-RED option will now be available on the sidebar. Alright, so Node-RED is up and running, and because the add-on supports ingress, there's no need to open ports in a router. So if you have remote access set up, you'll be able to open Node-RED securely from Home Assistant anywhere you are. Now let's jump into the Node-RED editor and go over the layout and the different sections that it has available. So the editor is separated in several sections. At the top you have the header, which has a deploy button, and the menu. On the left you have the palette containing all the available nodes that you have installed. In the middle you have the workspace where you can drag and drop nodes and wire them together to create a flow. On the right you have the sidebar, which contains panels that provide useful tools. For example, the information panel, which shows details about a selected node. There is also the debug panel, which displays messages that are passed to a debug node connected to a flow. We are going to look at the debug node later on and check out the benefits of using it when creating flows. Alright, so we went over the Node-RED editor. Now, let's create a flow to trigger an entity in Home Assistant. Because we're using the Node-RED add-on in Hassio, the Home Assistant nodes are already pre-installed, and there's no other configuration required for Node-RED to communicate with Home Assistant. There are a total of 12 Home Assistant nodes that we can use. However, to get started, we're only going to look at the event state, call service, and the current state nodes. The event state checks for a state change on a specific entity, and then it outputs that change to trigger a particular command in a flow. The call service is used to send a request to Home Assistant to trigger a service, for example, to toggle a light on and off. The current state gets the last known state of an entity and can be used to trigger different commands depending on that state, kind of like using an if statement. As an example, let's create a simple automation that will turn my desk light on and off depending on the state of my computer. So, if the computer is turned on, it will turn the light on, and if it's turned off, it will turn the light off. Okay, so to listen for a change in the state of an entity, we're going to use the event state. So drop the node in the workspace and then double click it to open the configuration panel. Set up a name for the node. The server is already configured to connect to Home Assistant, so no need to configure that. Then enter the entity ID to check for a state change. In this case, it will be the computer switch. However, I'm going to use an input boolean instead to be able to show you this example. As you notice, as soon as you start typing the name of the entity, the autocomplete opens to make it easier to select the right entity. To save the changes, click on Done. Next, we're going to use a switch node that allows us to set up two outputs, one when the computer is on, and the other one for when the computer is off. Drag and drop the switch node in the workspace and connect the event state node to the switch node. Open the switch configuration panel, set up a name, and then set up two rules, one for on and the other one for off. click on Done, and the switch now has two outputs. If you hover over each output, it will show you a label with its value. Now, to send the command to Home Assistant to turn the desk light on or off, we will use the Call Service node. So drop it in the workspace and connect the on output from the switch to the Call Service node. Set up a name for the node, the domain set it to light, the service to turn on, then enter the entity ID for the desk light. The data field we're going to leave it empty because we only want the light to turn on. However, if you have a light that you want to turn on with a specific brightness or color, you could set up the JSON information in the data field. The data field can be expanded and opened as a text editor by clicking on the three dots on the right side. This allows typing the JSON information in a more comfortable way. Alright, so we set up the call service node to turn on the desk light, and we connected it to the on output on the switch. Now we need to do the same for the off output. To make it easy, you can copy the call service node to turn on the light by pressing Ctrl+C, and then paste it below with Ctrl+V. Then connect the off output from the switch to the call service node. After that, open the node and edit the name and change the service from turn on to turn off. Now, before we deploy the flow, we want to connect a couple of debug nodes at the end of the flow. Then, using the debug panel, we can see the message that is sent. Click on deploying, and you'd notice that when the automation is triggered, it will show you the message that was sent through the flow, including the date, time, and the node ID. You can click on the node ID, and the debug node that received the message will have a flashing dashed outline around it. Okay, so that wasn't so hard to do, right? Now, let's say that we only want the automation to turn the desk light on when it's dark outside. Also, we wanted to check the state of the light before sending the message to turn the light on. We can do this by using the time range node and the Home Assistant current state node. So, between the switch and the call service node to turn on the light, drag the time range node and drop it on top of the wire to insert it into the flow. Then open the node and set up a name for it. The latitude and the longitude are set up automatically for your location. However, you can still manually edit if you need to. After that, set up the start time to sunset and the end time, set it to sunrise. Now drag the current state node and drop it in between the time range node and the call service node. Then open the node and set up a name, enter the entity ID for the light, then set the if state to on. This will create two outputs on the node. The first one will pass the message to turn the light on if the current state of the light is off, and the second one will just hold if the light is already on. Next, copy the current state node and drop it between the switch and the call service node to turn off the light. Then open the node and edit the name and change the if state from on to off. After that, click on deploy to save the changes. Now, if we look at the entire flow, we can easily understand what the automation is doing. When the computer is turned on, the on message is passed to the switch, which then goes through the on output, and if it's nighttime, it passes the message to turn on the desk light. Then, when the computer is turned off, the off message is passed to the switch, which then goes through the off output and checks if the light is on, and if it is, it sends the message to turn off the light. Otherwise, it just holds. If we put it to a test, we can see that the whole automation works as expected. Alright, so I hope that this guide has helped you understand more about Node-RED and get you started. On future videos, I want to cover other nodes and create a few more automations that you guys can use. If you have any suggestions, definitely let me know in the comments below. Also, all the steps that we follow are posted on a written guide on my website, which I usually try to keep it updated with any changes, so definitely make sure you check that out. You can find a link in the description below. Alright guys, thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, definitely consider subscribing. I'm always bringing new videos about home automation every month. Anyway guys, I'll see you in the next video.